Everyone is a beginner when they start something new, right? Yes, guys, in this video, we are going to see some of the beginner photographer mistakes that you can avoid when you are new to photography, when you are beginning your photography career. Yes, guys, if you're new to the channel, I'm Cario from India. We talk photography, filmmaking, editing, and many other social media stuffs that help creators like us. So yes, guys, if you're new here, do hit that subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get regularly notified whenever I make a video. Yes, guys, now without wasting any time, let's get into the video. Welcome back, friends. In this video, we're gonna see all the mistakes that any beginner would do from buying the camera till taking any shot. So yes, guys, I have just divided this video into such sections so that you can be aware of it towards the entire process. So let's start with buying your camera. The first mistake that any of you would do is buying the wrong camera. So guys, if you're serious towards photography, just do some research and just confirm what kind of specs that you have to have in your camera to achieve that basic quality of images. Don't just go to some brand as like everyone has that brand, or don't just blindly buy a camera because someone else has it. So all the camera brands have their basic cameras, but I won't suggest buying them. If you are new and if you are serious, consider, just underline that point. If you are serious towards photography, don't buy a basic camera. It's better to go for a second-hand camera with high-end specs than buying a basic camera. For example, in Canon you have different series like 1000 series, 100 series and 10 series. For example, Canon 1500D, Canon 3000D and those are one series. Canon 700D, 850D something and all, that comes in the second series, and 80D, 90D and all comes in the third series. I would suggest to go for buying a minimum of 80D. I won't even suggest to go with 700D series, and 1500 or 3500D, I will never suggest that series, just because I know what that camera is capable of. Instead of spending those 40 to 50k bucks in a new basic camera, just my suggestion, guys, do some research and just figure it on your own, guys. It's better to buy a second-hand camera than buying a basic camera that has very low specs. I would suggest to buy a Canon 80D second-hand camera than to buy a Canon 3000D in first-hand. So we are completing the first mistake that anyone would do. I hope you are clear. So let's move to the second mistake. Yeah, we have spoken about camera. The next one is the lens. Of course, whenever you buy a camera, they are gonna give you a kit lens for free. But do you want that? Decide it yourself. If they are giving that, it's not actually for free. It's at a quite a small price, right? Comparatively to the other lenses. They are gonna give you those lenses with a camera. But do they work good? Do a research on them, guys. Guys, the things now I know about photography, if I had known that before, I would have never gone for buying this kit lens. I would probably go with a prime lens. I would have bought the body of the camera and gone with a prime lens instead of buying this kit lens, because it saves around 6 to 8 thousand if you are buying the body alone for this camera, I'm saying. So for every camera, there is a body only option available. Just go for that. You don't need to worry about, that's my suggestion, guys. Do a research and decide, because you cannot just blindly follow someone. Just don't go for the kit lenses unless you actually need them. I just felt like instead of buying these two kit lenses, if I had this lens a long back, I would have taken even better images. I am damn sure about that. Yes, guys, the cheapest lens that every brand gives is the 50mm prime lens. If you want to know more about this lens, just check out. Instead of buying the kit lens, go with lenses separately. First lens, I would suggest the 50mm prime. Apart from that, you can just go ahead with any lenses based on your needs. Don't just blindly buy those lenses unless you have a need. Okay, whatever you buy, research, decide, and then buy. Yes, guys, now we have bought the camera. Let's move to the next mistake that we all do after buying a camera. So the third mistake is protect your camera. So there is a high chance that you can easily damage your camera sensor. The main thing that you have to do is whenever you just put your lens, don't just open it like this and simply put it like this. This may result in a lot of dust getting into your camera and it may spoil your camera sensor. That's why whenever you put a lens to your camera, hold your camera upside down and put your lenses. This ensures that your camera is highly protected and no dust just enters your camera. So main thing, protect your camera and its sensor. So now we have bought the camera, bought the lenses, protected your camera, know how to use or how to fix the lenses. The next thing is capturing your images. So while capturing your images, the best myth that anyone would say you is always shoot in manual mode, only then you are a good photographer. Just ignore that myth, guys. Nothing like that. But I would suggest not to go with fully auto mode. Just use the semi-auto modes in your camera, those like the aperture priority and shutter priority modes. Start using these modes first, and whenever you master them, you can also go with the manual modes. So don't just blindly jump to the manual mode. It would be quite difficult for you to handle things and get the perfect exposure. So instead of that, you can go with the aperture priority mode. Even shutter, maybe the next, you can go with the aperture priority, because when you have control over aperture, you are basically in aperture priority, you have control over the aperture. So when you have control over the aperture, you can control the background blur and sharpness of the image and how depth is in the image and bokeh. Everything can be controlled in that aperture priority mode. So you will also have a larger amount of light let in whenever you use widened aperture like f1.8 or f2.8, something like that. So just go understand all the modes. Don't just blindly believe that myth whoever says like you are a good photographer whenever you master your manual mode. Nothing like that. Just start with all the modes in your camera, learn how to use this aperture priority, shutter priority modes, and then you can go proceed with your manual settings as well. So if you want to know about all the modes of a camera, just check out, I'll give a card here, I have made a special video on that. So moving on to the next mistake that anyone would do as a beginner is using the histogram. So every camera, literally every camera, has the histogram options in it. So whenever you take an image, you will have this histogram in your settings in the menu option. So this small box that you can, I don't know if it is visible. This small box is the histogram. If it is totally towards the left, it's underexposed. If it is totally towards the right, it's overexposed. So you have to have this histogram visible on the screen so that you can judge if your frame has good amount of light. So for example, now I have closed my lens with the lens cap, and that's why we have the histogram totally moved towards the left. It's totally underexposed as it's totally dark. Now I will remove this lens cap. I hope you can find a difference, right? The line is at the center. See? So that's how histogram works. It's basically on the amount of light and exposure on your frame. If it is underexposed or overexposed, this histogram is going to help you find that. And really, using a histogram really helps you to take better images so that you can be a better photographer. Yes, now moving on to the next mistake that we do is not using a lens hood. So what is the use of this lens hood that many people, you would have seen many photographers just putting them in the front of their cameras, right? So not using a lens hood is also a mistake. A lens hood helps you to avoid any flare or glare on your images, so that whenever sunlight falls directly on the lens, you would have those kind of lines or flares on those images that you take. This may be useful at some times, but the other time it may not be helpful, or it may be distracting the main story of the image. So that's why a lens hood is used. The correct use of lens hood is required. The next mistake is not following basic photography rules. So guys, if you are into photography, you need to follow those small basic rules that really makes a difference on your images. For example, the rule of thirds or symmetrical angle photography, like use of symmetry, maintaining a perfect horizon. Sometimes if you see some of the images of beginners, you can easily find like the horizon will be like this. Horizon in the sense, whenever, for example, take a beach shot, you have a line that separates the beach from the clouds, right? If the line is like this or like this, how the photo would be? Not good, right? So these are some of the basic photography rules that you must follow as a beginner photographer. So do follow them from the first itself, so that you can take better images. You can really find a difference in your images itself. So yes guys, follow basic photography rules. So moving on to the next mistake is, do not service your camera until you have an issue. So yes guys, it's the mechanism inside this small thing is not an easy one. So unless and until you really have an issue, don't just service your camera. Oh, I have bought this camera, it's been 1 year since I have not even serviced once, so I'm going to service my camera. No, never do that. Unless and until you have any problem on the camera, never service your camera. That's my suggestion. You can also research on Google as well. The thing is, the sensor is very sensitive, guys. Servicing can also affect it in a different way. So that's why even when I went to the service center once, they itself suggested me, unless and until you have any problem on the camera, you don't need to service it. Maybe a dust removal, or I had an issue kind of like I had some white spots on my sensor while taking images. That was due to like dust settled on the sensor. At that time, I just gave it to service and got that issue alone cleared and did not service the entire camera. So whatever issue you have, just fix that alone. You need not worry to service the entire camera once in a year or something like that. There is nothing like that. Service your camera only if you have any defect. That's it. Moving on to the next mistake. Use those things that actually protect your camera. Do not remove this camera strap, or also you must be using an UV filter. When you accidentally drop your lenses or even the camera, this small UV filter, it doesn't cost more than 500 or 200, 300 something, but it's really going to help you to protect your lenses. So just use this UV filters and even these camera straps until you get more comfortable with your camera, because sometimes you may lose your camera from your hold. So it's better if you have your camera strap on your neck to provide more safety, and also use these UV filters to protect your lenses. So even more guys, this camera straps has the capacity to provide more stability while just shooting your images. You can take a video simply just holding it tight so that you have more stability. So don't just ignore these small things that protect your camera and even help you in many other ways. So moving on to the next and the final mistake that I want to share with you, don't be still while taking your images. Just move around your frames. So just imagine you are just taking an image like this, but just think, find angles where you can find a better image than this. Shoot an image, see it, no, I'm not satisfied, I want to find a better angle, I want to find a better view. Find different perspectives whenever you take an image, so just moving around makes your images far better. These are some of the 10 mistakes that I wish I would have known whenever I started photography. That would have made me a better photographer soon than how actually I am now. Hey guys, sorry my mobile got drained off and that's why I'm shooting in my GoPro. So yes guys, I hope this video was really helpful for you to understand all the basic beginner photography mistakes that you would probably do. And if yes, do hit that like button. And if you're new to the channel, just hit that subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get regularly notified whenever I make a video. That's it for this video. I hope you have a beautiful new year. Happy new year guys. We'll meet you in another video. Until then, it's your Cario signing off.